Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's indeed a pleasure to be here amongst all of you. I have with me on my dais Sri Rakesh Kumar, Chairman IEML, Sri Hari Dadu, President of the IHE, and this house to a wonderful gathering of young minds and bodies from the hospitality sector. As we begin to come out of the shadows of fear of the COVID-19 pandemic, it's hugely uplifting to see such a large gathering in this beautiful program tonight. I congratulate India Expo Mart for taking the lead in organizing a real physical show with us with all due precautions. It's wonderful to see the shining stars of India's hospitality sector gathering here this evening. And events like IHE 2021 will go a long way in promoting India's exhibitions and conference sector, which has been in a state of inactivity because of COVID-19 pandemic and the consequent lockdown. This would also show the confidence in the world's fastest and the largest vaccination program against the COVID-19 virus. I truly wish and pray that the worst of the pandemic is behind us and that the better days lie ahead for all of us, and particularly for the hospitality industry and tourism industry that were ground to a complete halt during the two phases of the lockdown. The pandemic also saw the finest which is there in humanity. There was handholding by citizens, both during the first phase and more so in the second phase, when the variant virus galloped its way all the way from Kerala, Maharashtra to NCR and up and above. As a police commissioner, I am a first-hand witness to how this hand-holding helped us in pulling us out of that dark hour of the pandemic. Especially the magnanimity and adaptability demonstrated by the hospitality sector in all of the NCR as they opened up their doors, their resources, their talents and their hearts for the use of as makeshift hospitals and quarantine centers at the peak of the COVID-19 crisis. It was a demonstration of national duty at its best. I wish we do not have such challenging moments, but when the moment came, you all stood up to that deadly hour. I congratulate you. I have no doubts of the resilience of the hospitality sector and its capability to help India tide over the future crises as well. As the unlockdown got underway a few weeks back and people started returning to markets, malls, public places, I noticed that the greatest crowds were thronging at the restaurants and the hotels. It is one industry that has bound back to brisk business, and many other continue to languish behind due to pandemic related economic assets. This is because the hospitality industry provides the opportunity to nourish the most basic of the human instinct, the instinct to socialize and to form bonds and connections. I am reminded of a legal provision in Ireland where the Irish hospitality, it was mandated by law, and the idea was to encourage a culture of hospitality, promote trade, and most important of all, exchange of ideas. My personal favorite has been the hospitality sector of Irish, they say that when you are on the streets of Dublin and if you ask for a way, in all probability, the person may take you home for an Irish coffee and then drop you to your place. That is the standard of hospitality which the Irish have set up. And nonetheless, Noida, which is completely a cosmopolitan city, it can boast of a very robust hospitality sector here that supports the kind of business and investment opportunities, lifestyle and quality of life that any offer in a city can make. We also have huge opportunities coming up in the form of the Jewar International Airport, which will bring in a lot of domestic as well as international travelers. Associated with it is the Film City, which is again a mega project of UP government, which will give a lot of opportunities for the hospitality sector. I, on behalf of my police force, pledge you my complete support to grow in an atmosphere of safety, security and stability. We have a lot to learn from the hospitality sector. I have long admired the courtesy, sense of service and customer satisfaction and the patience that is imbibed by the members of the hospitality sector. There are no mean qualities and it can be quite a challenge to keep up with them in the face of stubborn or assertive clients. I often encourage my police force towards such emulation during training or motivation sessions when I advise them on how a people-centric police force of a democratic nation must conduct itself in the 21st century. I am tempted to again quote, train people well enough so they can lead. Train people well enough so they can lead. Treat them well enough so they don't want to leave. This is the kind of my personal experience which I wanted to share with you this August gathering. Way back in 2000, I was on a training in Italy. And like all the government servants, we were on a very shoestring budget. So every weekend we would decide to rush to the neighboring parts of northern Italy. And we reached somewhere around the Alps in a city which was bordering northern Italy and Switzerland. So it was a very typical bread and breakfast. Got up early for the breakfast and after taking in as much of breakfast as possible to survive through the day, two of my colleagues started putting in those small muffins, a piece of an orange or a bottle of a juice. And then the elderly lady who was watching over, she understood the sentiment. And to her utter surprise, she came back with two brown bags and stuffed it with all the muffins and the juices so that we could survive throughout the day. That was the ultimate lesson in hospitality. I would not bore you further with my personal anecdotes. I conclude by welcoming all of you present here tonight for partake of this celebration of excellence in the hospitality sector and draw inspiration from the award winners. They have shown the way. We must emulate their excellence and strive to provide the best possible service in our respective fields of work. Excellence alone will drive this district and the country forward towards a safer, more prosperous and more sustainable future. God bless you all. Thank you so much.